For Williamson County, this is Week in Review.
Hello, I'm Evan Six at Independence High School, and today the NFL Network has come to do a piece on assistant principal Kevin Dyson and his life after football.
We had a sock off, and today is the 50th day of school, and we had root beer floats, and we went to the library.
This is like sour whipped cream.
We have been learning about pumpkins, and we've been learning about the length and how big they are.
We're counting feet in 10.
This week at Hillsborough School, we are celebrating
Red Ribbon Week.
We're promoting a healthy lifestyle by saying no to drugs and alcohol. And this young lady is...
Woman.
For Red Ribbon Week, we're doing a door decorating contest to help promote the dangers of drugs and alcohol.
Berkeley is going to Disney World.
Today, we're celebrating Berkeley's wish with Make-A-Wish.
She wished to go to Disney World.
Good morning. We are here at Heritage Elementary for their fun run. Are you guys excited for your Booster Club fun run?
First grade, we've been learning about bats.
Bats are amazing animals.
Today, the sixth grade group at Grassland Middle School went to the Nashville Zoo, and we had a great time.
At the zoo, we got to feed birds, and you could hold a little cup of nectar and they land on your arm.
We're doing poetry out loud.
We're memorizing poems to present them from the classroom.
And they have to be 12 lines or longer.
It's fun.
This weekend, the Franklin Theater production put on a play, Acts of Murder. We had four shows. It was a great turnout.
Today, we're rapping about diffusion.
Yo, this is relocation. Cultures are spreading from nation to nation.
Diffusion moves from place to place, just like magic in your face. Diffusion creates diversity, despite its adversity.
This week at Fairview, we have the Fairview Book Fair for this whole week. It's pretty lit.
We have drawing for a basket full of books, and Katie is our winner.
Today we are in Broadcasting 2 class, and we are recording the next segment for our show, The Sting. And we are readying up the studio and getting ready to record.
Girls soccer is going to state! Woo!
We had our food drive at Fairview Elementary.
We brought snacks, cans, and soup.
The food we bring goes to Grace Works. We love helping out.
We're learning how to work with cameras and take videos and stuff. But we're learning how to work on Premiere Pro. We're like editing videos. And we're learning how to use green screens so you can make special effects and stuff like that.
This week we have our fall book fair going on. We have thousands of great books and lots of shoppers.
This week in iLab we're working on our project, which is a time-lapse video of makeup through the ages based on literary pieces.
We were learning about yellow fever and we did an experiment to see how it spread.
This was our 2017-18 STEM Fair at Scales Elementary. We had fifth grade students either choose a prototype of something or they had to experiment on something.
I built this robot using a Lego bottle.
I built this robotic spider.
This week we've been celebrating our book fair with Saddle Up and Read.
I had breakfast with moms this morning and now at the book fair shop.
I found this amazing book, I Am Pushing the Cat.
We're making our wish lists
and I hope my mom will get them for me.
Dr. Brown came to Walnut Grove today.
He taught us how to extract DNA from strawberries.
We put a strawberry in a bag, squished it, then put detergent and squished it again.
We need to know what DNA is because it makes us us.
We've been getting ready for this year's haunted house. It's gonna be so fun. We're gonna have a lot of things to do there, like the meat locker room, It's the Clown. We're gonna have a haunted hospital and much, much more.
We wanna thank all our parents and families for their generous donations to our Mission Possible fundraising campaign. Thanks to you, Mr. Loudon and I have survived the admin campout on the roof of BMS.
Welcome to the Brentwood High School Library.
Don't be afraid to check out a scary good book.
Sunset Middle School National Junior's Honor Society is hosting a movie night to raise money for charities.
Today I got to see a police dog, and my favorite part is that I got to pet him.
Today we went to the Discovery Center and learned about the wetlands.
What were our exercises that we did?
A pumpkin squat.
Oh, a pumpkin squat.
Today is January 1st.
We were just in language arts class and we were playing this really fun review game called Kahoot.
We covered sentence structure and parts of speech in 40 questions.
This week it was said we decorated pumpkins as book characters in the library.
Tell us about the lip sync contest.
My sister was like doing a crazy candy thing.
And which one was your favorite?
Ghostbusters.
This has been Week in Review.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
We were invited to bring our canines out and do a demo for the fifth grade class.
They were showing us police dogs, and they were showing us what they do, about how they bite, what they're meant for.
Today, the canine dogs came with a deputy, and we got to see like cool tricks. Like there was one where he sniffed out marijuana from the bag, and then he played with the ball, and we also got a pet one. We just saw dogs like perform a lot of tricks and like playing and stuff. And there's one dog who came over to us, and we got to pet him and stuff. I only got to pet him a little bit, but he was so cute.
We come to the elementary schools, the middle schools, to again introduce ourselves to the kids, try to make them realize that, you know, police are not scary. When they see canine unit, everybody thinks dogs are out to bite and attack, and they don't really understand what they truly do.
What I didn't really know was that they can sniff out bombs, tobacco, like all of the other drugs that we talked about.
I learned like that like a lot of dogs are like trained to do like really important things, and that they can do like really amazing tricks.
It's just fun to see the kids get excited about the dogs and what they can do, and then they go home and tell their parents that, you know, they saw these dogs and were very obedient, did what they did, and they wonder why theirs don't act the same way and whatever. So
we are getting ready for a robotics competition.
Oh, down, 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 down.
Forward, forward, forward.
Down, down.
We are designing a robot and coding to make the robot do what we want it to do.
This is our first competition. We are definitely nervous, and we think the stakes are high.
I think since it's our first year, we're not like all-stars, but I think we have like a good chance. We practiced a lot on the remote control, and so I think we're doing pretty well.
There's two parts of driving. One, they get to drive with the controllers, which is similar to video games that they do. They do have to program the controller.
Something as simple as going forward. There's multiple steps.
One of our main vocabulary words that we talk about in this class is perseverance. When they start Robotics 1 with me the very first day, I tell them they're going to get frustrated.
You think it's fun, and going into the class, you're like, yay, you know, we've got a year-round robotics team. This is so cool. But getting all of the parts together and all of the hard work and stuff that goes into this is so difficult.
You tried like a lot of times, and you've tried multiple things, and you've asked your teacher, and you've worked through all the problem solutions you can, and it still is not working. It can be frustrating.
What's so fun is the fact that this is like the first time I've ever seen a group like this come together.
You feel like really accomplished because it's a lot of work. It's not just something as simple, really simple. So it's fun when you get all of your, like, at least like 80 lines of code, and your robot is exactly what you want it to do.
You're learning jobs of the future. You're learning how to do computer programming like CSS, JavaScript, maybe even HTML if you're doing more coding in the class.
And it's really fun to see that your robot is doing what you want it to do.
It's just such a cool experience, and I can't wait to see how we turn out in the competition.
I would say we're sort of ready. We're ready as we're gonna be.
I think they are absolutely going to just do a fantastic job this weekend.
Yay! Or the coach.
Well, we did a dedication ceremony for the playground we built.
Congratulations. Woo!
Dr. Garrett wanted a new playground, but she wanted it to be designed some way special.
And I brought back the sixth graders who are now at Spring Station.
She asked us and Miss Bridget's group to design a playground for the school.
They had to create a budget, they created a blueprint,
There were specific standards that they had to meet in order for this playground to come about.
We started mapping out ideas onto the plan.
It took a while.
We've been in the classroom and they've been trucks like everywhere just working on it, everything.
But it turned out really good.
It looks awesome. In fact, I wish I could play on it actually. There's musical instruments, there's swings. They made sure when they developed the playground that they could make it where all different types of children could enjoy it.
It's important that we have playgrounds that can keep somebody healthy.
These students worked so hard and they created this vision that is now here.
It makes me feel fulfilled, like you did this. It makes you feel like this sort sense of energy, like I can do anything.
It feels good that I'm a part of the team that helped build this. And it's just, wow, look where we are now, right?
It feels great, because we're not here anymore, but our sign will be here forever, hopefully.
The fact that they just had a hand in creating something for other students, and the fact that their name is on a sign, knowing that they've left a legacy, it's just a really exciting opportunity and time here at Chapman's Retreat.
And now a lot of kids can come and play on this playground.
Very excited because I realized that I've actually left my mark.
This is our own creation. It's our legacy. This is what we leave behind.
I'm Special Agent Dennis Fetting with Homeland Security Investigations. We investigate crimes on the internet. I want to keep you and your child safe from digital dangers. So I want to talk about Snapchat. When I go and I talk to a group of students who have phones, I would say 80% to 90% of those children who have phones or devices have Snapchat. Snapchat is extremely popular here in Williamson County, and there are some vulnerabilities that parents need to be aware of. Parents need to realize that while Snapchat claims that information can disappear or go away, that's not actually true. There are apps available on the iTunes Store and Google Play that can be used to capture Snapchats that have been set to delete. There are many different ways that that data can be saved. So while children think that Snapchat has some sort of a time limitation, they need to realize there is a permanency to that data. Also, those pictures and that data sits on their device. It can sit on Snapchat servers and it can be recovered forensically and by law enforcement. One of the big vulnerabilities of Snapchat is a new feature which is called Snap Maps. The way that Snap Maps works is if your child has Snapchat and they are enrolled in Snap Maps, their friends and followers can see everywhere that they go and everything that they do at all times on a map, which is generated by Snapchat. Your child needs to opt out of Snap Maps by going ghost or ghost mode. We have found in several of our investigations that because Snapchat is so popular, adult predators love to go on Snapchat and create fake profiles acting like someone that they're not. And then once they become friends with teens, with juveniles, with children on Snapchat, they can see their activities, see the photos that they post, and via Snap Maps, see where they go, what they do, and what their daily routines are. While Snapchat is fun for photo filters and for communicating with friends, Snapchat needs to be set to private. Children need to realize the permanency of data, and children need to get out of or go ghost from Snap Maps. To report suspected online child exploitation in Tennessee, contact Homeland Security Investigations at 615-664-5501.